Hey, what's up, fellas? How you doing, man? Antonelli here.
Hey, what's going on, guys? How we doing? Matt Antonelli here. So what we're doing is looking at the top hitters from the 2020 MLB draft. We're going to start with the number one overall pick, Spencer Torkelson, first baseman out of Arizona State. He was drafted by the Detroit Tigers. And so I want to break down his swing. We're going to talk a little bit about him, talk about some of the things that I think are really, really impressive. I'll play a swing here for a second. We've got a couple swings to look at today. We're going to look at this swing right here. While playing for Team USA, and then we're going to look at one of his Arizona State swings. So first things that kind of stand out to me before we even get into the swing is he has a ton of power. So he hit 25 homers as a freshman. He led the entire Division I baseball. Hit 7 home runs in the Cape Cod League, which is a ton. So a lot of times, you know, college baseball, you're playing with metal bats. And so sometimes people say, oh, well, it's a metal bat. Oh, he plays in Arizona State. Oh, the ball flies. Well, the Cape Cod League is always a great league to go to. You swing wood bats. You're playing against top competition. And so if you can have success in the Cape Cod League as well as in your normal college season, it's a pretty good indication that you can really hit. Now, when I watch him swing, I've seen him hit pull-side home runs to the absolute moon. He has light tower power, but I've also seen him drive like two-strike pitches that are breaking balls away from him that he'll drive out of the stadium to right center field. So he doesn't just have a ton of power. He can really, really hit. And one of the really impressive things that I have seen him do a lot, and that's where we're going to start talking about his swing here, is that I've seen him repeatedly pull his hands inside to get the tough pitches on the inner part of the plate. And not only does he get to them, but he can hit them out of the park, which is really, really impressive. So he has a chance to be like a four-hole hitter in the big leagues. He could get there really, really quickly. People are already saying, does he even need to go to the minor leagues? Pretty much every player goes to the minor leagues. So he's going to go to the minor leagues, but it could be really, really quick. Okay, so let's look at his swing right here. I've played it a bunch of times, but this is one of those examples right here where this ball is in. Look at this pitch right here. This is a tough pitch to hit right here. And so he's able to get to this pitch. I've seen him do this a bunch where he gets to this pitch and hits it fair, and he hits it out of the park, which is amazing. And so in my opinion, the only way that you can really do this is you've got to have a really, really solid path. You've got to be from the inside. You've got to be able to stay short. And the impressive thing, again, is not only can he get to this pitch, right? And when you see him do this, you know, we talk a lot about letting this lead arm right here. This lead arm has to work up as the rear arm works under. As you can see, the barrel starting to turn deep. It's from the inside. Like, look at how tight this is to his body, right? And so he's clearing room for him to be able to get to this inside ball. Now, from this position, if you attack from the inside, you can, if the ball's away, you can always let the barrel out. Right, if the ball's middle, then you can let the barrel out there. If the ball's in, I can stay in and hit this ball in here. But again, the impressive part is that not only can he hit this ball in here, but then he can take a two-strike pitch down and away, and he can hit it out to the opposite field. So some players have a swing that, you know, they can get to the inside pitch, but they can't get to the outside pitch. Other players have swings where they can get to the outside pitch, but maybe can't get to the inside pitch. For me, watching him, and this is particularly impressive for a power guy, is that he can get to the outside pitch, he can get to the inside pitch. He can hit the ball out of the park on the outside pitch, he can hit the ball out of the park on an inside pitch. So I think that's probably the most impressive thing that I've seen with him. Again, that ability to get inside the ball, to be inside it, stay inside. You know, a lot of our videos we talk about swinging from in to out. This is from in to in. He stays in because this ball is so tight to him. But big guy, able to control the barrel, has a really solid path, able to drive the ball out of the park. Now this one right here, this is during the college season. Here's another pitch that he's going to hit out of the park to left field. Another ball into him. And he does a really, really good job again of staying inside, pulling his hands in. Again, you see the lead arm working up. Rear arm works under, gets behind the ball. Really short, compact swing for a big dude. Gets a little bit more forward in this one, but still able to drive this thing. You can see the catcher, you know, you can see the catcher extending inside here. So this ball's coming in, barreling in on him, and he still gets there, hits it out. So he does this with metal, the last video was with wood. And so the other thing that kind of stands out to me when I watch his swing is there's not a lot of moving parts. It's a simple, it's a really, really simple, simple swing. So he doesn't need a lot of movement to create huge power. Right, that's a simple swing. And he's strong. He's about 6, I think he's listed 6'1", 220. So it's a really, really short swing for a really, really strong, strong kid. So I'm excited to watch this guy as he continues to develop, work his way into the minor leagues, and then eventually to the major leagues. You know, it looks like they're going to try him at third. I don't know if it's going to work. But worst case, you know, he goes back to first base. He's probably going to hit you. You know, he's probably going to be a four-hole hitter in the big leagues if he continues to progress. So let me know what you think in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel if you're a Tigers fan. Let me know if you're excited. I think you got to be excited with this pick. But let me know what you think. Thank you to our patrons on Patreon for supporting the channel. And we'll talk to you later.